Bonjour à tous.
Hello to everyone. What a pleasure to be back at the Palais des Congrès, Porte-Maillot in Paris. In a few moments, the presentation of the course of the 2022 Tour de France. Hashtag TDF 2022, and for the first time in history, the presentation of the Tour de France Femmes with Swift.
Ladies and gentlemen, what a delight it is to be with you this morning, right here in the Palais des Congrès, in the heart of the French capital, Paris. A very warm welcome to you all. It is great to be back physically with you right here in Paris indeed. Now, before we get the show on the road, I would like to talk to you about a little device. This is a cell phone. This is a mobile phone. We all have one. We all use one. But today, for the next hour and a half or so, we'd like to please ask you to put it on silent or vibrate. But of course, you can take as many pictures as you want and flood them on social media, hashtag TDF2022. Take as many pictures, put them on social media, but do it silently. Thank you very much, mesdames et messieurs. Ceci est un téléphone portable, un téléphone mobile, un accessoire très utile dans la vie, vous en conviendrez. Mais on va vous demander pour la prochaine heure et demie de bien vouloir mettre votre téléphone sur silencieux ou sur vibreur. On vous invite par contre à prendre un maximum de photos, d'inonder les réseaux sociaux, hashtag TDF2022, évidemment pour les poster. En tous les cas, ça nous a beaucoup manqué l'année dernière. On est très 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 heureux de vous retrouver physiquement ici au Palais des Congrès de Paris, avec évidemment avant l'allocution traditionnelle de Jean-Étienne Amaury, la présentation de Christian Prudhomme et désormais de Marion Rousse. Je vous propose d'accueillir comme il se doit dans quelques instants, mesdames et messieurs, les coureuses et les coureurs du Tour de France. Voilà, on va démarrer avec Noémie Abgral qui nous retrouve sur scène. Direction le Bélarus avec Alena Amyaliuzic, championne nationale, vainqueur des Jeux européens du côté de Bakou. Kasper Asgreen pour le Danemark, vainqueur du Tour des Flandres. Deux fois deuxième sur les routes du Tour de France, y compris entre Libourne et Saint-Émilion l'été dernier. Retour avec une coureuse française, c'est Sandrine Bidot qui nous retrouve sur scène. Le sourire angélique et puis le Danemark sera à l'honneur avec un triple champion du monde du contre-la-montre individuel dans les rangs espoirs. C'est Mikkel Bjerg. On poursuit toujours avec un homme, faut-il encore le présenter? Il a remporté trois étapes sur Paris-Nice, le Critérium du Dauphiné, trois sur le Giro d'Italie, à la Vuelta à Espagne, à l'ancien champion de France, Nasser Bouhanni. Encore et toujours l'accueil des coureurs direction l'Australie avec Neve Bradbury qui nous retrouve. A very warm welcome to you on stage for the official presentation. La Suisse avec la championne nationale du contre-la-montre individuel. On salue Élise Chabet. Et on poursuit avec une Française très applaudie, championne de France sur route du contre-la-montre, Audrey Cordon-Rago. Dans le sillage d'Audrey, faut-il encore le présenter? Il a porté le maillot à pois sur les routes du Tour de France. Deuxième de la Flèche Wallonne, c'est Benoît Cosnefroy. Mesdames et messieurs, juste derrière, un homme qui est désormais à la retraite, qui va profiter de la vie. On salue Ludwig de Winter. Dans le sillage de Ludwig, place à la France de nouveau avec Barbara Fonseca qui nous retrouve sur scène. On continue avec le Danemark, il sera à l'honneur à l'occasion du grand départ 2022. Il a gagné à Liège-Bastogne-Liège, il a remporté le Tour de Lombardie, deux fois le Critérium du Dauphiné. Il a terminé trois fois deuxième sur le Tour, c'est Jakob Fuglsang. Regardez ce garçon, mesdames et messieurs, on se souvient du Tour Malais en 2019, on se souvient de sa 11e place sur les routes du Tour, 3e à Liège, c'est David Gaudu. Et dans le sillage de David, il a terminé deux fois septième sur les étapes du Tour de France. C'est Elie Gébert. La Nouvelle-Zélande, Kiwi in Paris. Welcome to you, welcome to Ella Harris. Et on continue là aussi avec l'homme de Romans-sur-Isère, ancien maillot blanc de meilleur jeune sur les routes du Tour de France, vainqueur d'étape sur les routes de la Vuelta. C'est Pierre Latour. Cécilie Ludwig nous retrouve sur scène. Deuxième de la Flèche Wallonne Femme, on va poursuivre l'accueil ici avec un coureur qui s'est régalé du côté de Brest et le Tour de France l'été dernier, c'est Valentin Badois. Le Luxembourg, elle a été 12 fois championne nationale sur route, 15 fois du contre-la-montre individuel. On salue Christine Majerousse. Et regardez qui est derrière. Troisième à Orcières Merlette, troisième à la station des Rousses. Premier Français du Tour de France 2021, c'est Guillaume Martin. Guillaume Martin qui cède la place à Rudy Mollard. Vainqueur avance sur les routes de la course au soleil. On continue avec l'accueil des coureuses qui débarquent sur scène avec Ashley Moulman-Passio qui représente l'Afrique du Sud, plusieurs fois championne d'Afrique sur route. On salue la Française Kristina Nenadovic qui nous retrouve. La Pologne a l'honneur avec Katarzyna Niewiadoma. Dzień dobry, Katarzyna. On va saluer également l'arrivée d'Aurélien Paré-Peintre, vainqueur du Grand Prix cycliste de la Marseillaise, 15e du dernier Tour de France. Gabriel, pilote Fortin, nous retrouve. On salue l'arrivée de Margot Pompanon également. Et mesdames et messieurs, la Colombie est à l'honneur. Il a gagné le Giro d'Italia, la Vuelta a España. Deux fois deuxième du Tour de France, triple vainqueur d'étape. C'est Nairo Quintana. Derrière Nairoman, c'est Greta Richiou qui est avec nous pour prendre place pour la première fois de l'histoire. Et l'homme qui nous retrouve, la coiffure la plus aérodynamique du peloton international, ancien vainqueur de Paris-Chauny, on salue Anthony Turgis. La Slovénie à l'honneur avec Urška Žigart qui va nous retrouver sur scène. Urška Žigart, évidemment championne du contre-la-montre individuel. Et puis la France représentée avec la championne de France. Mesdames et messieurs, les applaudissements du Palais des Congrès pour Evita Music. Il a brillé il y a quelques jours encore à l'avenue de Gramont du côté de Tours. Super combatif du Tour de France l'année dernière. C'est Franck Bonamour. Mesdames et messieurs, regardez la scène très attentivement. Regardez ce garçon. Mark, I'm going to get you to stop in the middle of the stage right here. Le record absolu l'été dernier pour ce coureur qui a gagné des étapes sur les trois grands tours. Il a été champion du monde. Il a remporté Milan-San Remo. Il a ramené le maillot vert et il a égalé le record du plus grand nombre de victoires d'étapes précédemment détenues par Eddy Merckx. C'est le missile de l'île de Man. C'est Mark Cavendish. On poursuit, mesdames et messieurs, avec une institution de la discipline. Elle porte le maillot arc-en-ciel, le maillot de championne du monde, l'accueil du Palais des Congrès pour Elisa Balsamo. Une championne du monde peut en cacher une autre, un autre en l'occurrence. Il va s'arrêter gentiment également au centre de la scène. Il m'a dit ah, « tu me fais pas rester trop longtemps hein, quand même ». Mais en tous les cas, on va pouvoir l'accueillir comme il se doit, mesdames et messieurs. Le double champion du monde, vainqueur de 6 étapes sur les routes du Tour de France. 5e du classement général, triple vainqueur de la Flèche. C'est Julien Alaphilippe. Julien Alaphilippe. Et comment ne pas finir en fanfare avec l'homme qui a tout changé il y a deux ans de cela. C'était à l'occasion de l'édition 2020, lorsqu'il remporte le contre-la-montre en battant son compatriote Primoz Roglic pour aller arracher une première victoire un an plus tard. Il revient pour gagner le double vainqueur du Tour de France, vainqueur sortant, il est slovène, c'est Tadej Pogacar. Tadej Pogacar qui nous retrouve. Quelle ambiance électrique ici au Palais des Congrès de la Porte Maillot de Paris. What an atmosphere indeed. We're just going to give a little time for our friends, the photographers, to of course take some snapshots here. On va simplement donner quelques secondes à nos amis les photographes, bien sûr, qui vont immortaliser le passage des coureuses et des coureurs dans l'enceinte du Palais des Congrès de la Porte Maillot de Paris. Merci à toutes, merci à tous d'avoir fait le déplacement, d'être avec nous en cette belle journée de présentation officielle des parcours de la plus grande compétition de cyclisme de la planète Terre. Profitez-en bien.
Mesdames et messieurs, ladies and gentlemen, let's now welcome Jean-Étienne Amaury, president of Amaury Sport Organization.
Please welcome Jean-Étienne Amaury, president of Amaury Sport Organization.
Your Royal Highness, Mr. Minister of Denmark, Madam Minister of Sports, ladies and gentlemen, to all the elected representatives, the representative of the UCI, welcome to the champions. Ladies and gentlemen, hello and welcome to the presentation of the 2022 Tour de France. Thank you for joining us this morning. The ASO teams and I are delighted to see you here in the Palais des Congrès after a presentation that was cancelled last year due to health conditions. Global health crisis, teleworking and video conferencing, the sports and events sectors have been hit hard by COVID. Fortunately, to the delight of cycling and its fans, the Tour de France took place in 2020 and 2021. The success of the last two editions was possible thanks to the support and commitment of the Tour's partners, whom I would like to thank wholeheartedly. The cities and regions of the Grand Départ, Nice, Brest and Brittany, as well as all the communities that hosted the Tour, the prefectures and security forces, police and gendarmerie, the International Cycling Federation, the UCI, led by David Lapartien, whose re-election as head of the UCI I welcome, and finally the media and commercial partners. Every edition of the Tour de France is a joint effort, but the last 2 years have highlighted the collective spirit that is essential for the success of such an event. Year after year, and even during the pandemic, the popularity of the Tour is undeniable. A large and warm public at the roadside cheers the riders every day as the peloton passes. This kindness of the public, who are in direct contact with the champions, is a unique characteristic of cycling and a real asset for this sport. In Europe, 150 million television viewers also watched the Tour, and 840 million people around the world connected to the Tour via social networks. In 2022, the Tour de France will start in the city of Copenhagen in Denmark. The reason why we have chosen such a destination for the future Grand Départ, the most northern ever organized, is not only because of the majestic setting of the city of Copenhagen, but also because of its exemplary cycling culture. The Danish capital has the distinction of being the most cycle-friendly city in the world. There are more bicycles than residents. The Tour wants to promote cycling as well as a means of daily transportation. And what better example than Copenhagen to inspire cities around the world? Driven by this same ambition to promote cycling in the city, this year we launched the Tour de France Cycle City label, Villa Vélo. The aim is to encourage municipalities to take initiatives to encourage cycling on a daily basis. This first edition of the label has aroused great interest with 80 French, Belgian, Dutch, Spanish and Irish cities applying. Another ASO initiative, the first edition of Paris-Roubaix Femmes, took place on the 2nd of October and attracted almost 1.5 million viewers on France television. Women's cycling will again Women's cycling will again be in the spotlight in 2022 with the creation of the Tour de France Femmes. This major event in the women's cycling season, thanks to Zwift, will be one of the major events of the season. We'll start in Paris for a week of competition. Marion Rousse, director of the Tour de France Femmes, and Christian Prudhomme will give you more details in a moment. Now let's have a look at some images of the Tour de France Femmes with Zwift. A teaser.
En 2022, nous allons ouvrir la voie. Des championnes de talent vont émerger. Nous allons inspirer des générations de femmes. Affronter les parcours les plus difficiles. Nous allons nous approprier la route et partager notre passion. Le monde verra ce que nous voyons. Ressentira ce que nous ressentons. Nous gagnerons nos galons. Et nous ferons l'histoire. Ensemble, créons le plus grand événement cycliste féminin au monde.
Mesdames et messieurs, veuillez accueillir Christian Prudhomme, le directeur du Tour de France. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Christian Prudhomme, the director of the Tour de France.
Hello, welcome to all of you. It's a real pleasure to see you all here at the Palais des Congrès physically, although you're wearing a mask, but to see you here is great, although even if you never abandoned us last year. I'd like to thank France Television for their help. Last year, our presentation was on Stade 2. So we'll be presenting two courses. I'd like to talk about women's cycling and its development. ASO was created in 1992. The feminine version of Flèche Wallonne was created in 1998. We've developed La Course avec FDJ. We've developed a parallel women's race during the Vuelta, now soon to be 5 days long. We have created Liège-Bastogne-Liège and Paris-Roubaix just 2 weeks ago, and with amazing progress in terms of media attention and television coverage, with more than 2 hours of coverage. We've also organized men and women's races at the Tour of Qatar, Tour of Yorkshire, Tour of California that we helped to develop. We, of course, could go faster, but we were active during all these years. The challenge now is not to create a race. We need to create a race that lasts for a long time, that remains in 100 years. And that's why we really have to work on this. I'm not going to give you names just for publicity, but the help of a company like Zwift is essential in the creation of the Tour de France Femmes. With Zwift, we have Liv and the faithful partners of the Tour de France, LCL, of course, in the adventure, like Leclerc, like Skoda, like FDJ, like France Television, of course, like the UER, with a two-hour coverage of the race for this fourth week of the Tour de France, and of course all the collectivities, the cities, which are your terrain of expression. The road does not belong to us. It is offered to us during a certain period so that you can manage exploits. It was obvious for us, that's Amaury Sport organization, with Yann Le Moyner, with Pierre-Yves Tour, that we need a woman to direct this event. And one name came out, a young lady who was a French national champion when she was 20. She's also a TV consultant at France Télévisions after starting at Eurosport, and is also the deputy head of the Tour de la Provence since 2019. This young lady, you know, all know her. Let me now welcome on stage the director of the Tour de France Femmes avec Zwift, the first director, Marion Rousse.
Bonjour.
C'est une ovation.
It's an ovation. Standing ovation almost. It's a new challenge, of course, new responsibilities, but a real honor to be the director of the Tour de France, Femmes avec Zwift. Women's cycling has evolved year after year, and I'm delighted. And since I finished my career, so much has happened. New teams have started, new races, more media attention, more budget. And these new races that we've discovered with Paris-Roubaix just 2 weeks ago are a great accomplishment. So thank you very much to all the ladies. It was fantastic to commentate the race, an honor for me. And this race that we have now, a real jewel that we have to cherish and that we need to develop. And I'll be fighting hard for it. Marion, it's 11:53. And it's up to you to pronounce a ritual sentence. It is now time to discover the course of the first edition of the Tour de France Femmes avec Zwift. The challenge for us all, our challenge together, is to make sure that more and more people talk about women's competitions. I remember the words of Marianne Vos during a meeting that we had, two-time Olympic champion, world champion on the roads, track and cyclocross. She had told us, you can organize races, but you can also give us more media attention. And what she told us a few years ago, we had that in mind when we designed the course of the Tour de France Femmes avec Zwift. That's why the start will be on the Sunday of the Tour de France, just before the final main stage, and to have all the media present on place. That's why we've decided to leave Paris to give the women the prestige of their French capital. Paris, the Tour, the Eiffel Tower, the Champs-Élysées course, the Arc de Triomphe, 12 laps, and a novelty already. Indeed, there will be a KOM at the top of the Champs-Élysées after the ninth passage. Might sound strange, but it won't be the first time. It already happened in 1977 on the Tour de France. You were not born. The Champs-Élysées course, the same as the first editions of La Course. First edition won by Marianne Vos. She was wearing her world champion's rainbow jersey, already a symbol. Marianne Vos, who would go on to win again in 2019 in Pau. So a lot of symbols. And the next day, on Monday the 25th of July, we'll be in cinema at the Museum of the Great War in Meaux. The biggest museum, European museum, concerning the First World War. And there will be a homage at the start of the race to all the women who were essential during that first conflict. We will remain in Seine-et-Marne for all the course, 135 kilometers. We'll go through very nice sites, the castles of Vaux-le-Vicomte and Blandy. And there'll be a loop at the end of the stage. And that's one of the principles that we wanted to set, to have a final loops at the end of the stages. And it'll be the case in Provins with a tricky final part. Provins, who had also welcomed a stage of the Tour de l'Avenir.
De l'humanité, j'ai presque honte de parler sur la musique de Pachelbel. Canon en ré majeur, vas-y Christophe, n'hésite pas.
La cathédrale de Reims, c'est le cathédrale of Reims is also part of the World Heritage, essential city for women's cycling. That it was in Reims that for the first time in 1958, where the women's world championships in 1958. A few years later, there was a great battle between Jeannie Longo and Maria Canins. It was in 1985, won by the Italian ahead of the French. It'll be a tricky stage with five difficulties. The final climb on the final circuit, the Côte de Mutigny, 900 meters at 12%. Nice place to eventually win the stage. And before that, there'll be the Côte du Mont-Bernon.
A
place where Julien Alaphilippe triumphed. He had broken away in the final part and had captured his first ever Tour de France yellow jersey in Épernay.
Dans la ville d'Épernay, 18 maillots jaunes pour Julien Alaphilippe.
18 yellow jerseys for Julien Alaphilippe. And quite a few lions.
Nous allons continuer avec Champagne.
We carry on with Champagne.
Aussi, qui se conjugue au féminin et au masculin. Troyes.
And the city of Troyes, its beautiful houses, champagne that one will have to deserve on this stage, going from Bar-sur-Aube. And we asked two young professional riders from the Live cycling team to go and check out the course. Here they are in the middle of the vineyards.
Can you make a clap with your hands?
Ah, this one.
Oh.
On est bon.
You can do it with the feet too.
On y va, Sabrina?
Oui, on y va.
It's very beautiful here.
Yeah. Champagne. A lot of riders can do this. You see the climbers there, but also some classic type of riders. So, yeah, I think both. So a lot of can handle this.
Now you can look where you ride, but in a bunch you can't choose where you ride. So we'll make it extra plus. The speed will be also higher.
Now we can enjoy it over here, and then next year it's like full gas.
Like this.
Yeah.
I think if you have a little bit experience with cyclocross, you have an advantage if it's more slippery.
I can't wait to be in the race and to get that feeling also.
I'm happy the Tour de France is on our calendar now.
What did you think of my wheelie?
10 on 10.
Moi aussi, je leur mets 10 sur 10. Elles sont vraiment sympas.
10 out of 10 indeed.
Elles sont chouettes.
Great.
Les chemins blancs, qu'est-ce que vous en pensez, Marion?
What do you think, Marion, of these, of this course, of those?
La télé, c'est sûr que ce sera une étape incroyable.
Dans la voiture, track courses. You'll see in the car, it's really nice as well. It'll be a dangerous stage. You'll have to be very strong. After 68 kilometers of racing, we'll be heading towards the first of four gravel tracks, long courses, 4.4 kilometers for the longest one. It'll be difficult, a real classic for the girls. Day after, we will take off from Bar-le-Duc. Welcome to the Tour de l'Avenir last year. It's the city of the Michaud brothers and father and sisters and son, sorry. Another tricky stage there, a marathon stage from Bar-le-Duc to Saint-Dié-des-Vosges, 175 kilometers. That's 20 kilometers more than the last World Championships, especially after two difficult stages. Heading towards Saint-Dié-des-Vosges, we will be in the Grand Est region. 5 out of the 8 stages taking place in the Grand Est. And we will take off from Saint-Dié, the only city welcoming a start, sorry, a finish and a start.
Découvrir dans un instant au pied des Vosges, bien évidemment.
At the bottom of the Vosges, of course, we had been there a few years ago with the men's Tour de France. It's famous Tour de la Liberté.
Mais pour les championnes, Marion, ce sera une destination.
It'll be a tricky destination to head to and to finish from. And we'll go to Alsace. We'll be going to Rosheim. We will leave the Vosges to go to Barin. After 20 kilometers of racing and after the gravel tracks, it'll be a little bit easier. It should be a stage for breakaway riders. Although there's a hill with 10Ks to go. The Rose City, Rosheim, on the roads of the Alsace wines. 100% Alsace stage from Barin to Haut-Rhin, the day before the final stage. We will take off from Célestat with its rich cultural past, a city of handball. But for the riders, there will be three very difficult climbs. It will be a stage for the GC riders. So first we'll go up the Petit Ballon, then the Plateau Vasel. First passage on the finish line and the final climb of the day, Le Grand Ballon, the highest summit of the Vosges. And then we go towards the Markstein, where the stage will be decided. Eighth and final stage of the Tour de France, we will take off from Lure.
Camembert, l'un des premiers personnages de bande dessinée, c'était au 19e siècle. Tadej Pogačar, lui, n'était pas dans les bandes dessinées.
Where Tadej Pogačar started his stage to eventually win the Tour de France 2 years ago.
Et qui fera encore date.
A time trial that a lot will remember.
Tout sera encore possible au départ de Lure dans la dernière étape du Tour de France femmes.
Will it still be possible to win the Tour de France before this stage? Yes, indeed, especially with La Planche des Belles Filles, la super planche des Belles Filles. But before that, we have la Côte des Molières.
Le premier grand col franchi, c'était en 1905.
En 1905, et si vous voulez la photo de Marion avec René Potier, la stèle du premier vainqueur du Ballon d'Alsace, la photo existe, je vous le garantis.
There is a photo of Marion Roos and René Potier, the first winner of the Ballon d'Alsace. And then towards the Super Blanche de Belles Filles, 7 kilometers of climbing, with the percentages going up to 24%, with the gravel track at the finish. And at the summit, we'll know the winner of the first Tour de France Femme with avec Zwift. And two riders from FDJ Nouvelle Acadienne, Futuroscope, went to check out the course, Evita Music and Jad Viel.
À gauche, je vais te laisser prendre à droite tout de suite.
Je pense que ouais, ça va faire vraiment un beau spectacle. pour une première sur le Tour de France féminin. C'est énorme en vrai, du coup je me vois à l'envers là.
Le premier kilomètre est vraiment raide. Je pense qu'on va pas quand même tout donner dès le début.
Sur une montée pure, on arrive à peu près à la gérer, mais après une course de beaucoup de kilomètres, il n'y a plus de gestion, c'est vraiment à fond jusqu'à la ligne.
Ça commence à piquer un tout petit peu. Depuis 4 bornes.
La rampe, même après le gravel, rien que de la voir, en fait, ça fait bien mal aux jambes. C'est ce qu'on disait là en arrivant. C'est vrai que ça fait une belle ligne droite bien raide. Et après, c'est vrai que le gravel, bah...
Le truc, c'est qu'on ne peut pas non plus trop se mettre en danseuse. Donc, il faut avoir encore de la force pour pouvoir appuyer sur les pédales et pas pédaler trop dans la choucroute, comme on dit.
On dit dans la semoule.
Dans la semoule, non?
C'est dans la semoule.
C'est vraiment un final en apothéose avec un circuit, je pense, qui n'est pas commun par rapport aux autres courses. Donc, ça va rajouter un peu ce petit peps et la magie du tour.
J'espère qu'il y aura vraiment beaucoup de monde pour venir nous encourager et que ça nous pousse vraiment tout le long de la côte jusqu'à l'arrivée, quoi.
La super planche.
La super planche des belles filles, of course, and its final gravel course. Track, sorry.
Alors Marion.
So Marion.
Juge de paix, la super planche des belles filles.
It'll be decision time.
Trop grimpé, je pense même cette ascension.
To have climbed it.
C'est brutal.
It's brutal.
Des pourcentages toujours autour de
10%. With very high.
Il n'y a jamais un mètre de plat, donc on
gradients. Never flat.
Jamais récupéré.
Et surtout, you can't recover. And it'll come after 7 days of racing, so there will be big gaps at the finish.
Le Tour de France femmes avec Zwift ce sont
the Women's Tour de France with Zwift with standings and jerseys.
La victoire d'étape qui sera parrainée par Zwift.
Stage win sponsored by Zwift. The yellow jersey with LCL, the green jersey with
Liv.
Et il y aura aussi bien sûr le prix de la combativité, le prix de la combativité.
KOM jersey with Leclerc.
Merci Marion,
and Liv sponsoring the best young riders classification.
L'applaudir. Elle le mérite.
I think she deserves a warm
de la confiance et du courage.
Applause.
Et place aux messieurs maintenant.
Et maintenant, cap sur la Bretagne pour la suite du programme, la région
it's
Bretagne.
It's now time to
je remercie, vous savez que les parcours
go back to Brittany. Brittany that I wish to thank very much. Thank you for Brittany to have hosted the last Grand Départ. And thank you to Denmark and Copenhagen for welcoming us next year. Here are the best moments of the Tour de France 2021.
It's a game for you.
Yeah, of course. It was a game for me since I started, so I'm enjoying playing it, so yeah, I'm super happy.
Oh, a huge crash! Loads of riders go down.
Et Christopher Froome qui ne se relève toujours pas.
Here goes Julian Alaphilippe. The firework is lit.
Il a été énorme, Julian Alaphilippe. C'est bon, c'est gagné. C'est gagné, un Français en jaune.
Now, driven on by the dream of the yellow jersey, Mathieu Van Der Poel.
Il va aller décrocher donc sa première étape sur le Tour de France.
Mathieu Van Der Poel points to the sky. He remembers his granddad Poulidor.
I have no words. Really, I don't know what to say.
Pour sa première participation.
Chute, chute. Garrett Thomas pris dans la chute. Garrett Thomas calling the crash.
Roglic est tombé. Roglic est tombé. Primoz Roglic est tombé.
And that's a terrible moment for him.
Ah, il est encore une chute dans le peloton. Aïe, aïe, aïe.
Ça va tellement bien.
Aïe.
crash by Caleb Ewan tied up with Peter Sagan there.
Et du coup, c'est Tim Merlier qui sprint et qui s'impose.
What a finish.
Oh, what a day.
S'il va être repris, Bren Van Moor, il ne va pas s'imposer, que c'est cruel pour le Belge de l'équipe Lotto-Soudal.
Cavendish takes the stage.
Wow. Quelle est dingue l'histoire de Marc Cavendish qui renoue avec le succès sur le Tour de France.
Le Tour de France, c'est Tadej Pogacar.
Pogacar va assommer ce contre-la-montre.
It may not be the yellow jersey tonight, but this rider is stating that he is the rider to beat in this year's Tour de France. And Mark Cavendish wins number 32.
32e victoire.
Attention.
What a move this is.
Décisif.
This is quite dangerous because we have the yellow jersey and Wout van Aert going clear in a sudden split.
Et il est en train de céder. Il est en train de céder. Primoz Roglic à l'arrière du peloton principal.
Matty Moric. The yellow jersey is losing yellow right now.
C'est avec l'attaque de Pogacar. C'est Dylan Teuns qui va s'imposer au Grand Bornand à l'issue d'une étape dantesque.
Tadej Pogacar has ripped through the Tour de France like a tornado.
We did it.
And will be the yellow jersey tonight.
7 minutes 25 maintenant, 7:25, 7:25.
Alors que ça attaque avec Richard Carapaz et dans sa route, Tadej Pogacar.
An immediate reaction from Pogacar.
Et hop, il est parti, impressionnant encore, et personne n'est capable de le rejoindre.
And no one is able to respond.
Quelle journée pour...
What a moment for Ben O'Connor, what a moment for Australia.
On the climb of the Mont Ventoux.
Incroyable image, Jonas Vingegaard qui a décroché Tadej Pogacar.
Le maillot jaune, Pogacar est distancé par Vingegaard.
This is the crest of the Mont Ventoux for the second time. Wout van Aert goes over the top.
Immense, immense champion Wout van Aert.
He's a helper, today he's a winner. Nils Pollitt. Is this going to be the record of Max? Mark Cavendish, the Max missile, matches Max. 34 wins at the Tour de France.
Qui rejoint donc dans la légende du Tour, Eddy Merckx, 34 victoires d'étape pour Mark Cavendish.
If any one of my wins can inspire them kids to ride the Tour de France or the Tour de France Femmes next year, when they grow up, then that's what means the most to me, I think.
Bauke Mollema goes on the attack.
For Bauke Mollema, winner of the 14th etappe. Fantastic. Et c'est très très tactique. Regardez, séance de surplace presque avant le sommet du Port d'Envalira.
Sepkus, an emotional finish.
Et ce Tour de France, il sourit aux audacieux.
Seine Laufbahn, Glückwunsch à Patrick Konrad. Er gewinnt
And here goes the yellow jersey. Uran cracks now. Rigoberto Uran has cracked on the climb.
Uran était deuxième du général.
Richard Carapaz now attacks.
Il les a bien bluffés, Richard Carapaz. 100 mètres de l'arrivée.
100 meters to go.
Tadej Pogacar je krenio, zdaj Tadej Pogacar, ali bo uspel, da, Tadej Pogacar je zdaj pustil za sabo oba.
Vingegaard, deuxième du général.
Nouvelle accélération de Henrik Maas, seul coureur de Movistar.
Et Pogacar, voilà, qui va reprendre Henrik Maas.
Look at the speed of the yellow jersey. He's conquered the mountains. He's conquered the Tour de France.
Mais c'est bien lui le plus fort, Tadej Pogacar.
Car voici les derniers 200 mètres, 180 mètres, 160 mètres. Voici sous les acclamations de la boule de Bérenc. Tout le Béarn, les Tiquis, toute la Chalosse, tout le Pays Basque, tout le monde. Bravo Merckx, bravo Merckx, bravo Merckx, c'est un seigneur.
Here's a special moment. Eddy Merckx coming over to greet Mark Cavendish.
Fantastična, fantastična zmaga Mateja Mohorič.
Van Aert, top 10. Victoire de Wout van Aert. Wout van Aert remporte ce chrono.
Is on the wheel. Here goes the team of Jumbo Visma with Wout van Aert. Wout van Aert strikes. Cavendish gets ready. Who's going to get it? Photo on the line.
Et c'est Wout van Aert qui s'impose.
Van Aert is endklimmer, endtijder, tijdrijder, endsprinter.
Wow.
Eh ben, re-coucou.
Hello again.
Jamais dans son histoire sans...
Never before in its century-long history has the Tour de France started so far from the equator. Copenhagen is set to host the northernmost Grand Pass since the inception of the Tour de France in 1903. Copenhagen and Denmark are also a new frontier for the Tour, which continues to expand its borders. Denmark will become the 10th member of a select club established in 1954, with the Netherlands and Amsterdam, joined 4 years later by Belgium and Brussels, and later Germany, Switzerland, Luxembourg, Spain, Ireland, the United Kingdom, and the Principality of Monaco. When the Tour goes abroad, it becomes an ambassador for cycling and France. Starting further afield means prospecting for new supporters and fans, burnishing the credentials of the Tour and raising the profile of France. The slogan that encapsulated Copenhagen's candidature file immediately piqued our interest. The most cycling-friendly city in the world meets the biggest bicycle race on earth. And then we saw a multitude of people riding up and down the streets of the Danish capital in winter and summer alike. Back in 1913, Christian Christensen became the first Danish rider to enter the Tour de France. I remember seeing, when I was just a little boy, not 1913, but I remember seeing Mogens Frey take a stage win in 1970, the first time a Dane got a taste of glory in the Tour. In the last few years, Danish champions have become a true force to be reckoned with, no doubt galvanized by Denmark and Copenhagen's dream of hosting the Tour. We had 10 Danes at the Grand Départ in Brittany, and quite a few titles. The junior and U23 time trial world champions hail from Denmark, of course. Speaking of which, the UCI has just treated us to a splendid celebration of the World Championship Centennial. The host of the inaugural edition held in 1921 was none other than Denmark. The Danes are crazy for the tour, and let's now welcome His Royal Highness Frederick, the Crown Prince of Denmark.
Merci bien, messieurs, dames.
Ladies and gentlemen, first of all, I would like to congratulate the organization of the Tour de France, Mario Odile and Jean-Étienne Amaury, Christian Prudhomme and his teams. I want to tell you that I feel both great joy and pride to be here with you. I say this, of course, as a Dane, as our country is hosting the Grand Départ of the Tour de France for the very first time. As having a French father, I also say this because I have a love for the French and for France in my heart. This Grand Départ will strengthen the ties between our two countries and our two peoples. Hundreds of thousands of spectators will be in attendance for the kickoff of the Grand Boucle on the 1st of July 2022 in Copenhagen, and the following two stages on the 2nd and 3rd of July. The Danes will be able to enjoy the incredible spectacle of the most beautiful cycling race in the world. The riders will in turn discover Denmark, Copenhagen and its unique cycling culture, then the Roskilde Cathedral, Nyborg and the bridge over the Great Belt, heading to Nyborg, then Weiler and the ruined stones of Jelling and the historic town of Sønderborg. Last finished stage in Denmark. And they will also meet the Danes, a people who are passionate about cycling and the Tour de France. Cycling is really part of our DNA. It's a real culture. We ride every day to go to work, to school, to transport kids, to go shopping, but also just for fun. I went to pick up my kids with a bike recently. In Denmark, cycling is synonymous with health, sports, and ecology in everyday life. But Denmark is also home to a new generation of ambitious riders like Vingegaard, Mads Pedersen, Kort, Asgreen, Fuglsang, and Valgren. They share with all Danes the dream of a Danish yellow jersey at the Grand Départ in 2022. We invite the entire world to come and celebrate the event and to discover our nation, our way of life, our Danish way of life. My family and I will be among hundreds of thousands of Danes to celebrate this exceptional event when the cycling paradise hosts the world's biggest cycling race.
Accueille la plus grande course cycliste du monde. Je vous remercie bien.
Thank you to everyone, and long live the Tour de France.
Merci.
Thank you very much.
Merci.
To the Crown Prince,
merci infiniment votre attention.
His Royal Highness. I have a gift for you, not for you,
mais je crois savoir que
but I understand that your eldest son,
a le délicieux prénom de Christian,
called Christian, will celebrate his 15th birthday tomorrow. Here is the brand new Tour de France, new generation, for your son.
Qu'un champion gagnera, qu'une championne gagnera un peu plus tard, et celui-là, il est.
This one is for Christian, your son.
Petit pays sur deux roues. Le cyclisme fait partie de notre ADN et de notre identité. Nous roulons toujours, car nous roulons tous les jours. Nous avançons avec notre histoire derrière nous, de l'enfance à l'âge adulte et vers notre destination finale. Nous roulons. Bientôt, nous vous montrerons nos racines, notre passion pour le cyclisme. Nous sommes un pays de cyclistes. Nous roulons. À travers les forêts. Pour aller au travail. Pour le plaisir. Ensemble. Et pour nos rêves.
Jeg ser de mange tegn. Mændene har indadvendte øjne. Jeg ser mig selv på spring. Jeg rejser mig i sadlen, ser mig om for sidste gang. Jeg hører feltets hjerte slå.
Parfois, nous hésitons. Mais souvent, nous nous lançons spontanément sur notre vélo. Sortir avec notre vélo nous incite à voir grand. Et maintenant, nous accueillons la plus grande course cycliste du monde au Danemark. En 2022, nous vous montrerons notre amour pour le cyclisme et notre passion pour le Tour de France. Bienvenue dans un pays sur deux roues. Bienvenue au Danemark.
Je vais immédiatement rectifier une vérité historique.
Let me rectify something I said. The young Christian, son of the Crown Prince will tomorrow be 16, not 15, 16.
Le règlement de l'Union cycliste internationale permet aux organisateurs, merci David, des trois grands tours de solliciter une fois tous les quatre.
Once every four years, the UCI rules let the organizers allow the grand tours to start one day earlier. It'll be the case for Denmark and Copenhagen, all the meetings will take place one day earlier than planned. The press center and race headquarters will officially open on Tuesday, and a general briefing and team presentation will take place on the next day, Wednesday, the 29th of June.
Je suis en train de tout mélanger. J'ai juste oublié, me dit Christophe Briand, que j'aurais dû vous proposer ce que vous attendiez tous.
I just forgot to launch the presentation of the course. It is 12:31, and here is the course of the 109th edition of the Tour de France. I almost forgot. Here it is.
Mm-hmm.
We'll be right back.
Nous nous retrouvons donc mardi 28 juin.
So we'll be together on the 28th of June for the Presenton race headquarters opening. Then the briefing and team presentation on the 28th in the gardens of Tivoli. And finally the show will get on the road on the Friday, yes, Friday, the 1st of July. Believe me, the riders will set a scorching pace in the opening time trial, a pancake flat race against the clock on the main thoroughfares of the Danish capital. A record average speed seems within reach, perhaps over 55 kilometers an hour, especially because time trying is almost cultural in Denmark. The riders will have to settle for a pace and glance of the Little Mermaid in the only winding part of the course for discovering Amienberg, the winter residence of the royal family. The finish will be in the gardens of Tivoli next to the Copenhagen City Hall. 13 kilometers for the opening stage and already some gaps at the finish, certainly. We will then leave Copenhagen for Roskilde in Viking country in the morning of, on the morning of the second day. Roskilde, the capital of the kingdom for five centuries, who hosts one of the biggest music festivals in Europe every year. Water dominates the landscapes of this stage. We will gaze at fjords, ride down the coast, here and there. The final, an XXL version of what we already saw in the Dutch province of Zeeland in 2015. Promises to keep fans on the edge of their seats. Here, winds reign supreme, and the Pelotón will appear to be gliding just above the surface of the sea. We will discover the Great Belt before heading towards Nyborg, a medieval city that used to play a key role in the country's defenses. The Pelotón will roll out of Vejle for stage three. Vejle, named after the fjord that dominates its geography. The town was long renowned for its textile industry. After the loop, a shaped detour to see the Yelling Stones. There could be some wind in the final 15 kilometers, but we should expect to see a bunch sprints near the Sonderburg Castle, close to the German border, where the Danish former world champion Mads Pedersen claimed a stage of the Denmark tour. Even as after the start, Denmark will continue to provide inspiration for our ambition to strengthen the links between cycling in everyday life and the men and women of the Pro Pelotón, with Maxu spreading the message among the children. Tour of France Cycling Town label was launched last spring. It concerns 700 municipalities that hosted a tour stage at some point. A jury was set up in which the French Federation of Bicycle Users plays a key role and reviews the applications. It's time now for season two. Dunkirk, which was awarded 3 out of 4 bicycles for the label, hosted the Grand Départ in 2010, when a part of the prologue was held on the beachfront promenade. Fourth stage, the first one back in France, and more specifically in the Hauts-de-France region, will not be out of place in the thrilling opening week. A lot of climbs, 6 climbs for the KOM classification before heading towards Calais, where we hadn't been in 20 years. Look out for the majestic landscapes of Cap Griné and Cap Blanc-Nez. Lille, the Lille European metropolis, which already hosted the start of the tour in 1694, awaits us on the 6th of July for a stage that will mark the return of cobblestones to the tour after 4 years. There will be exactly 11 sectors, including 5 that have never featured in the tour or Paris-Roubaix, discovered by Thierry Gouvenou and his teams. Almost 20 kilometers of cobblestones between before the Pelotón heads to Wallers-Arambert in the Porte du Hainaut agglomeration community. It will be the tour's third stage finish in this mining area. 2 previous finishes were filled with sporting feats and excitement, first in 2010 under sunny skies, when Torhushov sprinted to the win from a small group. Then in stark contrast, in 2014 under the rain and in a sea of mud, that reminds us recent emotions on Paris-Roubaix, a crazy stage where Vincenzo Nibali laid the foundation of his overall Tour de France win. Dutchman Lars Boom took the spoils that day. Thursday, the 7th of July, we will leave Belgium in Binche, famous for its carnival. It will be a long, hard day, a grueling stage with a tough finish in France that should play into the puncher's hands. The closing kilometers will pit the peloton against a 800-meter wall at a gradient of 12%, followed by the final climb to Longwy, 290 kilometers, the longest stage of the 2022 Tour de France.
Peter Sagan s'était joué de ses adversaires.
Peter Sagan had won there in 2017 on the Côte des Religieuses, when Sagan was wearing the rainbow jersey for the third year in a row. Good things come in threes, as they say. We will be visiting Tomblaine in the greater Nancy area for the third time after 2012 and 2014. One in three people in Tomblaine is under 19 years of age, while two-thirds of sport license holders are women. The Vosges will be looming on the horizon. We try to avoid front-loading the course before the widely awaited finish. The field will cruise down undulating roads, dividing to La Planche des Belles Filles, the Super Planche des Belles Filles, like in 2019. Super Planche will host the grand final of the Tour de France Femmes, powered by Zwift, of course, several weeks later.
Ont su choisir leurs prétendants, mais juger plus tôt.
This is unbelievable. Chris Froome creating a bit of a surprise here this afternoon, gets the win.
Il a décidé de s'en aller tout seul. Regardez, regardez Vincenzo Nibali.
Fabio Aru, grandissimo.
Il y a 800 derniers mètres qui sont terribles et qui ne sont pas asphaltés.
Il est solide, Dylan Teuns.
Roglic. You can see the stress.
Et attention, parce que le maillot jaune de Primoz Roglic est en danger. Mais il fait une montée stratosphérique, Tadej Pogacar.
This is incredible. Oh.
The day after La Planche, we will be in Dole in the Jura department. Dole will be celebrating the 200th anniversary of Louis Pasteur, who invented the rabies vaccine, of course. Stage will be a Franco-Swiss affair, just like Lake Geneva, which you are seeing right now. Like Lake Geneva is already a contender for the podium of the most aesthetic backdrops to the tour. We'll pass past the IOC headquarters for a finish in Lausanne in front of the Olympic Stadium on a final ascent where the gradient hits 12%. While the IOC has called Lausanne home since 1915, the Union Cycliste Internationale only moved to Aigle recently in 2002. We will ride along Lac Léman in the first part of the stage among the vineyards. It will be truly breathtaking. Then we go inland. We will follow a very wide loop of 145 kilometers in the canton of Vaud, Valais and Fribourg. We'll go crescendo into the Alps. First categorized climb, worth noting, the Col des Mosses, an appetizer before the more extenuating Col de la Croix. We will then plunge back to Aigle and close the loop. Stage is far from over as the Pas de Morgin stands between the peloton and the French soil. Less than 10 kilometers further down the road, we will get to Châtel, which has patiently waited for almost half a century for the Tour to return. Stage 9 packs an altitude gain of 3,600 meters. We'll remain in within the Porte du Soleil ski area for the rest day in Morzine. Morzine will also host the start of Stage 10, held against the stunning backdrop of the mountains. It looks like it won't be really a mountain stage. We will make our way to Tournon-les-Bains and the banks of the Lac Léman. We will stay in the valleys, knowing that the worst is yet to come. The stage will not leave the confines of Haute-Savoie department. The finish line will be set at the Megève Altiport, just like the final weekend of the 2020 Critérium du Dauphiné. Megève and the Tour met only a short while ago. The first time was in 2016 when yellow jersey Chris Froome prevailed in a time trial. Thirty years after its magnificent Winter Olympics, we will be back in the loyal city of Albertville. Just like last year, and for the sixth time in 10 years, we will barrel down the Maurienne Valley, where our reckon teams say things should get pretty hectic towards the Lacet de Montvernier. We will go through Saint-Jean-de-Maurienne, from there to Saint-Michel-de-Maurienne and the slopes of the Col du Télégraphe. The riders will then go up the Giants, Galibier, leave Savoie to Haute-Alpes. Peloton will make a left in the village of Saint-Chaffret to tackle the daunting slopes of the Col du Granon, 11.4 kilometers at 9.1%. This stage has an altitude gain of 4,000 meters. It'll be the second time that the Tour de France goes to the Granon at 2,413 meters of altitude. At the time, back in 1986, it was the highest summit finish in the history of the Tour. Bernard Hinault, on that stage, had worn his last yellow jersey. Eduardo Chozas, Spaniard, had won the stage after a long solo breakaway. We'll get back on the road in Briançon, a Tour de France favourite since 1922. It'll be the 14th of July. The riders will first backtrack on their route of the previous day, heading to the Galibier before taking the descent to Valois. We'll still be in the opposite direction of the previous day, Saint-Michel-de-Maurienne, then into the valley before going up a long way to the Col de la Croix de Fer and advance from Maurienne to Oisan. After the Grand Maison Dam in the Isère department, the riders will dive to Bourg-d'Oisan before reaching their goal, the 21 numbered bends of the legendary Alpe d'Huez. At 4,000, from Briançon to Duez, 4,750 meters of climbing, the exact replica of the 1986 stage that everyone remembers, Bernard Hinault and Greg LeMond together, hand in hand. Their boss was Bernard Tapie at the time. We will also be celebrating the 70th anniversary of the Tour's first summit finish back in 1952. The Alpe d'Huez will forever be our first.
Départ de Lausanne pour la 10e étape. L'arrivée se juge aujourd'hui à l'Alpe d'Huez à 1800 mètres. En tête, Robic démarre. Il lâche le peloton. Mais Frostokopi part à sa poursuite. Le rejoint, le passe irrésistiblement. Copy est seul et termine premier à l'Alpe d'Huez où il prend pour la première fois le maillot jaune.
Fausto Coppi et le maillot jaune inspireront-ils les milliers de participants à l'étape du Tour, la plus célèbre cyclosportive du monde? Sans doute, en tout cas elle fêtera son retour, vous l'avez vu, enfin le 10 juillet prochain, soit 4 jours avant les professionnels. La 13e étape s'élancera de Bourg-d'Oisans, parfait complément de l'Alpe d'Huez, le 15 juillet.
The day after Bassi Day, we will go to the Romanche Valley and the Grenoble Metropolis. We'll be at the bottom of the Bassi, of course, go through Isère, before the main difficulty of the day, the Col de Parménie. It'll be quite a battle for the green jersey, probably. After Isère, we will cross the Rhône. We will then be 40 kilometers from the finish, and there could be echelons. The race to the finish is very favorable to sprinters before Saint-Étienne, where the line will be drawn near the Chaudron, the Geoffroy Guichard football stadium. The last finish in 2019 left us some great memories. Triumphant attack of Thomas de Gendt and a fantastic battle between Thibaut Pinot and Julien Alaphilippe together. Alaphilippe capturing the yellow jersey again. We will leave Saint-Étienne the next day for a stage that will evoke fond memories for Laurent Jalabert in particular, as far as Mende, where he had won in 1995 after a long breakaway. We'll be going up and down on very nice roads, then we'll be on plateaus at an altitude of 1,200 meters before starting a spectacular dive into the Val d'Allier, like in a canyon. We'll then go back up to the plateau. This will be a stage for the adventurous, stage for the daring, maybe. Unlike the last time, we will arrive in Mende from the east. And it'll be decisive, of course, La Montée Jalabert. We'll be in Rodez in Aveyron at the start of the stage, in the town of the Pierre Soulages, the painter, of course, known and recognized around the world for his use of the color black. Peloton will be more interested in green on Sunday, the 17th of July. The stage is designed for sprinters, but before Mark Cavendish last Sunday, the famous 24th victory that allowed him to equal Eddie Merckx's record, none of them had ever won in Carcassonne, where the breakaways until then always had the last word. It was a case, for example, in 2018, with the Danish victory of Magnus Cort Nielsen, who was also brilliant in the last Vuelta, also a stage winner on Paris-Nice, actually on the final day. For Mécénat Chirurgie Cardiaque, victory means saving children by raising funds so that they can be operated in France. The annual meeting on the roads of the Tour will therefore take place this time during this stage in Carcassonne. 373 children have been saved since the partnership with the Tour that started in 2003. Carcassonne will host us for the rest day. We will be able to enjoy the city, the castle, the ramparts classified at the UNESCO World Heritage. Carcassonne will put the peloton on the road to the Pyrenees towards Ariège. The difficulties will be concentrated in the second part of the stage, and among the riders, only those who have a certain predisposition for climbing will be able to dream of victory, if the leaders of the general classification allow them to, of course. Two passes will spice up the course. The riders will first have to climb the Port de l'Hers, 11 kilometers at 7%, and then the famous Mur de Péguerre. Péguerre, whose steepest slopes are at 18%, and which precedes the finish in Foix by about 20 kilometers. The elevation gain of that stage is 3,150 meters. On the 14th of July 2017, at the foot of the castle of the Comte de Foix, during a stage that was held in Ariège, Warren Barguil had claimed the stage ahead of his breakaway companions. We will be back in Saint-Gaudens in Haute-Garonne, the start town of stage 17 on the 20th of July. Here after the final stage, the last stage, right? It'll be a very difficult course, starting with a classic, the Col d'Aspin, and then immediately after the very pretty Ourquette d'Ancizan. We'll then return to the valley for a few kilometers, only before climbing to the col de Val-Louron-Azette, then plunging towards Loudenvielle and climb towards the resort of Peyragudes. Three HC climbs and one second category, a total elevation of 3,300 meters. The very steep 16% gradient of the Peyragudes altiport put Chris Froome in difficulty back in 2017. He had lost his jersey that day. Romain Bardet, on the other hand, had claimed the stage. The last mountain stage will start from Lourdes in front of the shrine, in, as it's like in 2018. It'll be short and dense. First part in the Pyrenean foothills. Climbs, descents, a lot of attacking probably. The riders will enter the Osso Valley before starting a climb towards a famous climb, the Col d'Aubusque. Grand premiere for television, that was back in 1958, live. After the Soulor, a brand new col, Spandel, discovered by the Route d'Occitanie, 10 kilometers at more than 8%. It'll be time for the last battle to the summits on the climb to Hautacam, total of 4,000 meters of elevation gain. Hautacam, where Vincenzo Nibali had definitely consolidated his dominance in 2014, he won a fourth stage in his victorious tour over there. Castelnau Magnouac, a small village of 800 residents, will welcome us 48 hours before the finishing period. We'll be in the Haute-Pyrénées. The local boy is, of course, Antoine Dupont, best player of the last Six Nations tournament, rugby player, of course, and a key asset for France during the next World Cup. It'll be a flat stage with a fairly hilly finish. We'll be by the Caïs Castle, owned by the Danish royal family. Question of the day, sprinters or breakaway rider? Who will win in Cahors, where the only stage winner is Jackie Durand? It was back in 1994. The leaders will be on high alert, and they know that the day in La Capelle Marival and in the Lot department will be crucial. On the program, a time trial, 40 kilometers long, long false flats, and two climbs in the final stretch, one measuring 1.5 kilometers at 5%, the other is 8% to reach the promontory of Rocamadour, the decider of the 2022 Tour, an exceptional sight, Rocamadour. We'll be at Paris La Défense Arena in Nanterre for the start of the last stage. That's where the rugby club, Racing Club 92 plays. We'll be riding on the roads of the beautiful Yvelines department, which has hosted the Grand Départ of Paris ever since 2011. In the French capital, we'll go through the Louvre, of course, that the riders adore. We'll go up the Champs-Élysées. The riders will circle the Arc de Triomphe, Place Charles de Gaulle, as they have done since 2013. After 8 laps, it'll be time for the final sprints and congratulate the winners of the 2022 Tour de France. From Copenhagen to Denmark, the 109th edition of the tour will include 21 stages, 3,328 kilometers, a route through four countries, Denmark, Belgium, Switzerland, and of course France, 29 departments visited, four countries and four mountain ranges, Vosges, Alps, Massif Central, and Pyrenees, four massifs and five summit finishes, two more than last year. We also climb higher, up to 2,642 meters at the Galibier. On the other hand, there will be fewer classified calls than in recent years, 23, as in 2017. There will be six mountain stages, five flat stages, seven hilly stages, and two time trials, nine new host cities. 2022 routes are, of course, standings and classifications. First of all, the LCL yellow jersey, won by Tadej Pogacar on the Champs-Élysées for the second consecutive. What a symbol it is.
To win in the yellow is something I cannot describe.
It's a nice feeling to have number one.
Aller chercher le maillot jaune dès la première étape, c'est vraiment incroyable. Je pouvais pas faire mieux, quoi.
Well, you can even plan something like this, I guess. It's incredible.
And now we are in yellow. We are prepared to defend.
The yellow jersey, for which LCL has been a partner since 1987 in Santini, which joins the Tour's big family for all our jerseys. Created in 1953 for the 50th anniversary of the race, the green jersey is sponsored. Mark Cavendish won for the second time after his success in 2011, 10 years earlier. The polka dot jersey, sponsored by Leclerc, won by Tadej Pogacar, of course. Leclerc with us for the third consecutive year. The white jersey, best young rider, is sponsored by Chris since 2015 and won by Tadej Pogacar. Continental will accompany the stage win for the fourth year. Bahrain Victorious team won the team classification sponsored by Named Sport. Lastly, the Antargaz Prize for Combativity was awarded to Franck Bonamour, super combative of the 2021 Tour de France, for his first participation. I'd like to take this opportunity to salute all our partners, whether they have just joined us or are faithful to the Tour for a long time. They deserve a round of applause.
N'hésitez pas donc à venir soutenir.
Please come to support cycling during the month of July. It'll be unique. From the 1st to the 31st of July, amazing stages for men, then women, 1 month of cycling at the highest level, live, on your television, on your phones, on your iPads, everywhere in the world. So 1st to 31st of July, two competitions, 109th edition of the Tour de France and first Tour de France Femme with Zwift. Vive le Tour, no, vive the Tours.
Merci beaucoup à Christian Prudhomme, merci beaucoup à Marion Rousse et mesdames et messieurs, merci à vous d'avoir été de la partie en espérant que vous ayez passé un excellent moment. Vous savez désormais tout ce qu'il y a à savoir sur l'intégralité des parcours du Tour de France, bien évidemment 2022 et le Tour de France Femmes 2022 avec Zwift. En tous les cas, on espère que vous avez passé un très très agréable moment et on a hâte de voir vos réactions sur le hashtag TDF 2022, inonder les réseaux sociaux. Un grand merci pour votre concours. On vous souhaite à toutes et à tous une excellente journée. Rendez-vous le 1er juillet du côté de Copenhague pour le Tour de France 2022. Très belle journée à toutes, très belle journée à tous et merci.